Wolf, you know, British officials have said their computer systems are constantly under attack from hackers, and they're now using some real creativity to recruit top talent to fight back.
Here's your challenge, 160 combinations of numbers and letters, and a countdown clock. You've got just a few days to your deadline. If you crack this code, could you be the next real-life James Bond?
Bond. James Bond.
Maybe not. But if you're a British citizen and you solve this cryptographic puzzle, you could be recruited for Britain's next generation of high-tech spies. Posted online, publicized on Facebook and Twitter, it's put out by the Government Communications Headquarters, Britain's version of America's National Security Agency, a kind of whiz-bang eavesdropping post whose mission is to help catch terrorists. This agency once posted job ads inside video games. An official there tells us this puzzle's gotten thousands of hits and at least 50 people have solved it. If you do that, you're congratulated, offered a chance to apply.
What do you think of this as a recruiting tool?
I think it's a great idea. One of the things that it does is it brings sort of awareness of the need for cryptanalysts, cryptographers.
Former CIA analyst Mark Stout is an expert on code cracking at the International Spy Museum in Washington. He says for people with reasonable training in math and computer science, this code probably isn't too hard.
What kind of crucial intelligence can you gather by code breaking?
Well, code breaking, signals intelligence as we call it, can be tremendously valuable because it's one of the rare forms of intelligence that, if done properly, if you can get access to the right things, will give you the enemy's intention. What are they really thinking?
Stout and other experts say governments like Britain's need cyber warriors more than ever. Officials at the Government Communications Headquarters say they want people with an interest in so-called ethical hacking. Illegal hackers need not apply. How will that play? Mark Mayfrey is a former hacker who co-founded a firm called EI Digital Security. He says sophisticated hackers might find this puzzle gimmicky.
The thing that I would have found funny or interesting as a teenage hacker would have been to actually hack the server that's hosting this challenge and actually change the challenge to have some funny message or some other thing.
Other cyber experts say the code is just too easy. An official at that British government communications headquarters says it's not designed to be overly difficult, more to promote awareness of what that agency does. Mayfrey and others say if that's the goal, then it's worth it to get teenagers and other young people excited about careers in legitimate cyber espionage. Wolf, there's a